He walked into the blacksmith's forge, a well-dressed man, his name was George. Said, "Good morning, smithy, just the man I want to see. My daughter's pony threw a shoe. I was advised to come to you, and if you could replace it, I'll gladly pay your fee." His daughter brought the pony in. The blacksmith's eyes could not take in the beauty of the lady standing by the door. And when she smiled and said hello, deep in his heart he felt a glow. From that day on, the blacksmith's life had changed forevermore. Her daddy was a wealthy man, owns many acres of fine lands, a 22-room mansion with a panoramic view. I've heard them say that love is blind. He couldn't change his daughter's mind. She fell in love with the blacksmith who made her pony shoe. On the day that they were married, she rode in a horse-drawn carriage, four high-stepping ponies, two were black and two were gray, with seats of satin lining and buckles that were shining. They couldn't match her beauty on her wedding day. So now you've heard the story of the blacksmith and the lady. Some might think it's fiction, some might think it's true. I haven't been to a wedding yet. Among the gifts the bride will get, someone will always give her a lucky old horseshoe. Her daddy was a wealthy man, owns many acres of fine lands, a 22-room mansion with a panoramic view. I've heard them say that love is blind. He couldn't change his daughter's mind. She fell in love with the blacksmith who made her pony shoe. Her daddy was a wealthy man, owns many acres of fine lands, a 22-room mansion with a panoramic view. I've heard them say that love is blind. He couldn't change his daughter's mind. She fell in love with a blacksmith who made her pony shoe. She fell in love with a blacksmith who made her pony shoe.